Hello kids, so today we are here with a favorite interesting topic, that is measurement. When you check out this video with your book, in your book the title will be given as physical quantities and measurement. Okay, so I have something and you need to tell me what it is. I hope you can see it. I'll come near to you, it will be far more visible. Now you all will be telling me, ma'am, these are sketch pens and these are 4 sketch pens. Exactly? Yes, these are sketch pens. When you said that it is 4, that means you are able to count. Yes? And when I'm holding any object in my hand, I call it as physical. And if you're able to count this, I call it as physical quantity. And when we are measuring it, we are learning measurement. Why do we require measurement? I hope you all can see there is a whiteboard present. Okay, I'm going to use the older trend which our ancient people were used to do. Then you tell me, is it the correct way or not? This is my hand. You can see there is a box here. Okay, I am going to now measure. 1, 2, 3, 4. But is it correct type of measuring by using the hands? So in older days, our ancient times, they used to measure by using the hand, or they used to use the footsteps. But accurate measurement we hardly used to get. So what they used to do? They used to later on provided us with different things which are present on the board. For different objects, we are going to now learn about measurement. So why measurement is required? Measurement is required for accurate value of objects. Now what is the meaning of accurate value of objects? Example, I'm having a sketch pen. I'll ask, children, can you tell me how much ink does this has? But as soon as I'm asking, I can't tell but without seeing or measuring it exactly. So for that we require a measurement. First object which I am going to show you here is, that is any line. Here I'm having a line which is marking from A to B, and for identifying how much it is, what I should use? Can I use my hand in measuring it? It's coming 1 something point like that. No, it's absolutely wrong. For that, I need to use a scale. So I'm having a scale and I'll just measure it in front of you and you are going to tell me. I hope you cannot, because the camera may not focus it. It is 25 centimeters. So how can I say it is exactly 25? Because I am able to do the accurate measurement by using the scale. But can I every time use scale to measure? Example, like my hair, I'm just using the scale and I'm trying to measure it. Is it possible for me to do it? No. For different objects, we need to use different type of things for measurement. Therefore, if we have like cloth, or we have a very big area, if I need to identify how much length of this whiteboard is. So for these objects, I will be using a tape. Okay, a tape. And this is called as ruler scale or a normal scale. So this is a tape which is helpful for us to identify the length of any object. So when I'm saying length, length is being measured with different things. Now on the board, you must have seen that it is written centimeter, meter, kilometer. Now what is this? This is nothing but standard unit. Now what is the meaning of standard unit? Standard unit is the international value. That means if you are traveling abroad. Now as you are, as this shooting is being doing, it is in India. But if you are watching this video or in France, Japan, any country there. So we need to have a specific value, right? So that we can tell to each and every people all over the world. So at that time, we need to use a standard unit, which specifies Now this 25 can be centimeter, meter, it can be anything. So therefore we use standard unit. Because it is an international value, we always write it in short form as SI. This is standard unit of international value. Right? So here we have seen it was 25 centimeter because I am using a scale. Okay? If I am using a ruler, so this will be taken as meter. But when I am driving a car, do I always carry in centimeters or meters? No, I will be using it in kilometers. I have traveled 60 kilometers per hour. I have traveled 480 kilometers per hour. Isn't it? So here we have learned about length, about centimeters, meter and kilometer. Now let us come to the next one, that is weight. Now what is this weight? I'm having this books in my hand and my hand isn't, I'm keeping both the hands parallel. You can automatically see that this is very much heavier. By seeing it, you can say that this is heavier. But can you exactly tell me how much this may weigh? We cannot say. So for weighing purposes, to identify the weight, we are learning how we are using it, balance scale or weighing machine. What is the meaning of balance scale? Balance scale we used to use for measuring vegetables. Vegetable vendor we when you used to go and there the person used to use the balance scales. And weighing machines is a type of machine on which you can even stand and just check out your own body weight, or you can keep this books on it and identify how much does it weigh. But when we are weighing it, we use the standard unit as kilo. That means how much kilogram does it hold? And if it is very little, like if I'm having a cap and I keep it on the weighing machine, will it give me kilogram? No, it will not. It will give me in grams. So the smaller units are in grams and the higher units are in kilogram. Now let us come to the next topic, that is liquids. I'm having water bottle. Here it is half filled, you can see it. But can you just tell me how much this water is? Is it something kilogram or some centimeters? No. For liquids, we have different measurement. Now, what is a different measurement? Different measurement is, if the amount of water is more, we calculate it in liters. If the measurement is lesser, we take it in milliliters. What is this ml? Ml is, your m has to be written in small letter and l is written in capital. This is also written in capital letter. I'll just show you. Just now I have shown you the water bottle. And can you see that it is written 100 ml? Yes. I'm showing you a sanitizer which is 100 ml. Right? Because the quantity in this is very less. But if I am going to measure this water bottle, it will be in liters. Are you understanding, children? So now we will be learning about the next topic, that is time. Time word you must have heard many times, isn't it? Every time the people around me say, I'm so busy, I don't have time, because to say these words. But now we learn what is exactly time. Time, when we are saying, we always say that there is a clock present, we have time pieces, and in new ones we have LED watches which automatically show us the value. But still we should learn what is time or how the clock works. On the clock, you must have seen there are three different hands. We call it as hands, okay? One which is very long, which is very short, and one which is very thin and it used to move very fast. This is the description which we used to give. Now what work does they do? Here the smaller part which is there, we call it as our hand. I repeat, it is our hand. H is silent. Okay, our hand. And the capital one, that means the longer one, will be called as minute hand. This is minute hand. And the dotted lines, this will be called as second hand. Okay? We say every time, you must have heard that time is very precious, time is very important. Why do we say like that? Because when we are saying time, time is a measurement which occurs in seconds. It occurs in seconds. We are measuring in seconds. So here, there is a measurement which you will be learning it, which is very easy, and we are going to use it in daily life. 1 hour, like here the time has been shown as 1 o'clock. That means 1 hour, if it becomes 2 o'clock, that means it has covered 1 hour. 1 hour will be equal to 60 minutes. Now, what is the meaning of 60 minutes? That means this minute hand has shifted itself in 60 parts. It has moved itself in 60 parts. It has covered 60 minutes. And one single minute will be called as 60 seconds. That means when this second starts to move, it will be moving in 60 seconds. So, can you tell me that in one single day, that means when you are seeing this video, on that day, how many hours do we have? One day, how many hours do we have? If you're thinking, think fast, or else I'll say the answer. I'm going to say the answer. So, answer is 24 hours. It's 24 hours we have. Okay? And in the same hour, we have 60 seconds and 60 minutes. That means 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, 1 day we have 24 hours, and if we need to calculate it into seconds, what we are going to do? We just need to multiply 24 into 60 into 60, you will be getting the amount, and this will be that much amount of seconds we are spending in one single day. Yes, children. This much amount of seconds we are spending in one single day. So you calculate it, you'll be able to know. Now, the next and the last topic, which completes your chapter, that is temperature. Why temperature is needed? You can see that I am actually sweating. This room is very hot. Yes, it's very, very hot. So, when I'm saying it's hot, how are you going to understand? Whenever we are feeling anything, if we are feeling cold or if we are feeling very much hot, so when we are using these words, we are actually telling about temperature. It is pronounced as temperature. Temperature is a measure of coldness or hotness. Example, I'm having an ice cream and noodles with it. Does both the taste same? No. But does one object is very cold and another is very hot? So when we are speaking the words hot and cold, we are actually measuring it on the basis of temperature. What is the instrument used for measuring temperature? It is nothing but thermometer. Thermometer is an instrument which we use to measure the temperature. Okay? By using it, we will be able to understand that whether the object is hot or cold. So we'll just quickly revise what we have learned, and you can learn it again and again. We have learned about length. That length is being measured with meter, centimeter, kilometer. Then we have learned about weight. Weight, to measure any object, higher the value, we use it in kilograms, and if it is lower value, we use it in grams. Then we have liquids. Liquids like Coca-Cola, water, anything. If it is higher value, we use it in liters. If it is lower value, we use it in milliliters. Time, example, clock, and here we have minute hand, hour hand, and second hand. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Now, time is also very important when you're seeing the video, because because in the video it will be specified in the corner right, yes, on the left side corner, that how much minute video you are watching it. So at that time also you are learning what? You are learning time. Okay, so here also when you are watching the video, we are actually telling you how much quantity it is. So we are again learning measurement. Then we have temperature. Anything which is measured in terms of coldness or hotness, it is temperature. Temperature is measured with thermometer. And one more thing, whenever we are measuring thermometer, at that time we use either Fahrenheit or we use Celsius. If you are in a lower class and you are seeing this video, then you only need to understand it is written with C and there is a small dot and we call it as degree. It is called degree. So here degree Celsius and this is degree Fahrenheit. So this much today, and we have learned the measurement topic. Rewind it, learn it again and again, and come to my next class next time. Thank you.